Hey guys, what up? Spearmong187 here. Welcome back for a new match of Shadow Era, where we are playing Victor Heart Striker. So you guys seen the new video on YouTube from Kyle? There he showed the new game, or well, say the new Shadow Era, the new features of it, and the 3D features and some other features. So if you haven't seen it yet, I recommend you to check out, just search on YouTube for Wilton Games and the latest video that he just uploaded. You can see the new version of Shadow Era. Well, I do like it a bit, but I don't mind still playing with this old gaming board. But what I do want is from the Shattered Fate cards, the card art. And that would be very very nice to have those finally. So we're playing against the Rothem, King of Layer. Until the start of your next turn, weapons you control have +3 attack and allies you control have +2 attack. That's not a bad ability, but I think also would be, it would be more playable if it costs like 4 shadow energy to activate. So let's see, he's a warrior, so I think this Legend Rises will come in handy. She will come in handy, Raven Gambit will, so I'm going to sacrifice Jasmine and unturn. So I'm playing a big Victor Heartseeker deck. Heartstriker, I always say Heartseeker. 50 cards, that's because I think Shadow Era will be a lot better with some more cards in your deck, especially against those, well, there are not much milling decks, but I do think there are some cards that you definitely want to play, and you can't play all the cards 4 times because then your deck would be so large. So yeah, you made some, I just made some decision with the Jasmine, like the cards like Alden, maybe remove one of them, playing 3 instead of 4, and just added some other cards that I really would love to play. I'm just going to see how that will work out. So there comes a gargoyle. Okay, that's not nice. And let's see here. Jack Frost is gay. Okay. That's fine, that's fine. Let's see, we do wanna, I think I'm going to get rid of the Soul Seeker. Yeah. We'll just cast this one. So two of these guys here are pretty angry. Don't know what's happening here. They're shouting at each other, but well, let's just focus on the game and try to get rid of this gargoyle. I always hate this card. But next turn we can reduce his health by 2-1, but I don't think we're going to use that because we want to use the Victor Heart Striker ability to get back this Raven's Gambit. That's one of the cards why I like Hunter class now. Especially Victor, I think his ability with wow, they are really pissed at each other, but yeah, I do think his ability with Raven's Gambit is really sweet. And also I played a lot of Banebow before, and I still play Banebow a lot, and I only think he's gotten better because of the Raven Gambit card. I don't think it's overpowered, it's just a good card. And Hunters will need good cards, so. So okay, this is what I already expected. So a Legend Risens will come in pretty handy. He gets +2 attack, so he can finish off this gargoyle next turn. And I will swing in his face for 2 with Puin. That's probably what's going to happen here. So that's another great card for Drunia. I think we're going to skip it. So we'll just make this one stronger here. Deal some damage in his face. Swing in by two. And we'll just enter in here. Don't keep the man waiting. When your hero kills an ally in combat, draw a card. That's a pretty nice one. It only deals one damage, but you can use your allies to swing in first, and after that let your hero swing in, or use his ability that already reduces the ally's health to one. So that's pretty sweet with this card. And I do think I only play one of them, because yeah, you don't want four of those cards in the deck. Maybe two, but I do think one is more than enough. And that's nice for him. I think I'm a separate circus edge. Well, overall, I think we're going to get rid of it. My cat will fuck you. Wow. These guys are angry. So if we hit him in the face with this, let's do that first. And let's hit him once more. How much does this have? 3. Should we cast this Jasmine? Yeah, why not? Let's just cast the Jasmine. How much does this have? 3 attack. Let's just cast this on the Jasmine. Well, I should have cast it on the Crusader, but it's already done some big things for me, making every attachment cost 2 resources left. So next turn we're going to swing in with our Heart Striker himself, taking some damage but moving the Berserker Edge. Yeah, that's what we're probably going to do. Unless he's going to cast something really scary here. Or we could also swing in with the Pewin and save ourselves some damage, of course. I do think even that's the more better option. But what I do like is this ability, yeah, with the Raven's Gambit. Now if you, especially when you have one in graveyard, you're going to disable him, or at least reduce his health to 1. You're going to draw back the Raven's Gambit, and you play the Raven's Gambit on the ally, and it's killed, and you get 2 cards. So I don't know what he's doing, he's thinking a lot or making some tough decisions. Jack Frost, the angry one. Wolf and Scout, you can view your opponent's hands. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, this looks like we're going to win this one. I can deal 6 damage now. He's going to destroy the Jasmine. He probably should because he used his ability. But I don't know. The start of your next turn, yeah. Yeah, he's going to use it. Okay, no problem. Let's get rid of They're all good cards. Let's get rid of this one, I think. Yeah, I don't know. Let's just do it. Use our ability, reduce him to 1. Play a 3 Raven's Gambit on him. Attack his hero, destroy his weapon. And we have some resources left. Play this one and hit him in the face for 5. And we'll just unturn. So he only got 1 card left, so I'm at a huge advantage with wrong, of course. So the Raven Gambit is still the top hunter card in my graveyard. And next to him I gain a new shadow energy, so... Here comes an Enrage. 10 health for him. Okay, no problem. Both of my allies are still alive. So this is a nice one. Yeah, we can sacrifice one. Why not? Let's play this one. Give her this one. So she can attack twice, so that's pretty nice. Attacking 5 more. So I do think next turn he's dead. And this is the first Rothem King of Leia that I play against. But yeah, his ability really should have cost like 4 resources. That'd be overpowered. I don't think so. It would be nice with some more turn 1 drops or with the Ace guy. I forgot his name. What's his name? 1 mana or 1 resources, 1 attack, 1 defense, haste, charge, whatever it's called. Can attack right away. Then you could pull off some nice tricks, but yeah, 5 resources, 5 shadow energy is really, really a lot. Oh my god. Why so angry? But I dreamed that I was losing to you. But when I wake up, my cat is. Oh my god. Yeah, those guys are really, really angry at each other. Shall I upload this video or not? Yeah, I'm going to do this. I'm going to upload this. So, let's go. Play. Or is he going to drop out? Maybe he's going Alter for Rage Quit. Because of my allies. They're really making fun of him. 8 damage. This is another 6. That's 14 damage exactly. And could be a lot more because Legend Rise is attached to this arena. Would mean a lot more damage. And I do think let's go yourself. This guy has really got an anger management problem. And there he goes, quitting the game, giving me a victory. Well, that's it, guys. We can do a little bit quick overview on this deck. So I have played like 3 matches now in this season, which of 2 of them were uploaded because I lost one. I won one match. Sorry. But that was pretty quick. Within 1 minute, so I didn't gain any rating points. So yeah, 3 Jasmine, 4 Puins. This is the new card album, new card art. I really like it. The Stormcaller as well. I haven't seen it before. This card art. The nice 3 poison arrows. Still some Server Ties. Leyline Nexus, 4 times Soulseeker because yeah, every hunter should play it 4 times. 3 times the spirit one, and this card just get better. That you can remove unless in the graveyard from the game, because nowadays you can use your graveyard for a lot of cards by removing some cards or bringing back some cards from the graveyard, or if you have like 6 cards in your graveyard with the Gravemonger card or something. So the spirit warden got a little bit better. Still play some perfect shots. Maybe I could remove those. And I should add some of these cards, this treasure. And Legend Rise is pretty good card, so yeah, maybe we're going to do this right away. Let's see here. Maybe I only have 2 of them. Let's see. Let's search for it. Here comes another Legend Rise, really good card. This one as well. Maybe I should add one of these, but. Yeah, I think I have 2 of these treasures. Yeah, that's the reason why I only have two in my deck, I guess. Yep. So, one Gruntless Double, Crusaders, this Knight, Arena. This one is really nice. All damage reduced for you. Everyone knows how hard it is to get rid of a worm. The 2/5 worm to reduce 2 damage. Or a gargoyle. This one is even more nasty because it's game plus 1 attack when it kills an ally. Some Raven Gambit's pretty important card. This one. Overwhelm. Just one of its random, just when I have enough allies in play. And you get to draw a card from it, so I think it's a pretty okay card. Target artifact or support ability is destroyed. Venom Flame Archer, so that's a pretty nice ally for only 3 resources and it costs 1 shadow energy to activate. So yeah, that's the deck. It's a bit random, but I do like to play it and it wins a lot for me. So that's it, guys. I hope you liked this match and this tech overview. We'll see you next match. Cheers!